Imam al-Bukhari, there's a famous story of his that's mentioned. You guys have probably come across it, or heard of it, or it was mentioned to you. That a group of people wanted to test Imam al-Bukhari's memorization. They wanted to test him. They wanted to put this man to the test, rahimahullah ta'ala. So they sat him down, and they said, Bukhari, we're going to narrate hadith for you, and tell us what you think. Tell us whether you know the hadith. That's all they asked him. Tell us whether you know this hadith. Have you heard of this hadith before? So they sat down. The first man, he read what? 10 hadiths. He mixed the chain with the wording. So he took a chain and the wording of the hadith that exists, and he changed it with the other one's chain and wordings. So they mixed it all up. So whenever one would narrate a hadith, he would say to Bukhari, do you know this hadith? So the first one started, he mentioned the chain and he mentioned the hadith. He said to Bukhari, do you know this? Bukhari said, I've never heard of this. They look at each other. Subhanallah. They did the second hadith like that to him. He says to Bukhari, do you know it? Bukhari says, no, I don't. I've never heard of this. Subhanallah. He finishes his numbers, his amount. They go to the next, and then the next, and then the next, and then the next. Every single one of them does the same thing to him. When they all finish, Bukhari says, all of the hadiths which you guys have mentioned, I've not heard of them. But what I have heard of is, and he's, to me personally, when I read the story, what shocked me was not the fact that he knew the hadiths, because I was expecting him to know the hadiths. But what I wasn't expecting, and this shows his memorization, was he knew each person, the chain they got wrong, and whose chain they were using from the 10 that were sitting in front of him. So he'd say to him, the first hadith that you mentioned, in that order, in the sequence they mentioned it, your chain that you read is the wording of so-and-so's. Take his chain and give him your wording. That's the correct. Next hadith that you used. And he crossed them all through. And they stood up and they were shocked with who he was, rahimahullah ta'ala. You might all think to yourselves, that was at the time of the early people. Okay, mashallah, Allahumma barik. I've seen people today of a great caliber like that. Hayyun yurzaq. People are alive who I've seen memorize Dawaween al-Sunnah, the Kutub al-Hadith, Biri Jaliha, with his chains of narrations. They'll tell you every narrator in that hadith, how many times he's come in the Sahih. Bukhari, for instance, and Abi Dawood and Tirmidhi, and how many times? Are you with me? If you don't believe me, go on YouTube and write Hufadh al-Sunnah. There's a program done by a sheikh in Mecca, Sheikh Yahya al-Yahya. He started a program where he called it Hufadh al-Sunnah. And he made them memorize Sahihain, Bukhari and Muslim. And he asks them on the spot. It's a competition. You know how people get asked questions in the Quran competition? They get asked the hadith and they read it. And he's got a very strong program of how to memorize these books of hadith.
ثلاث من كنا فيه وجد بهن حلاوة الإيمان حديث من؟
أنس بن مالك.
سباب المسلم فسوق وقتاله كفر.
حديث ابن مسعود رضي الله عنه.
إن الله تابع الوحي على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم وكان أكثر ما كان الوحي يوم توفي رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم حديث من؟
أنس بن مالك.
إنه قد قشبني ريحها وأحرقني ذكاؤها.
أبي هريرة.
أكمل.
إنه قد قشبني ريحها وأحرقني ذكاؤها فصرف وجهي عن النار فلا يزال يدعو الله فيقول أن لك إن أعطيتك ذلك تسألني غيره فيقول لا وعزتك لا أسألك غيره فيصرف وجهه عنه.
كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إذا دخل الخلاء قال اللهم أني أعوذ بك من الخبث والخبائث.
أنس بن مالك.
تتعاقبون فيكم ملائكة بالليل والنهار. من أدرك ركعة من الصلاة فقد أدرك الصلاة.